An infectious disease expert says fully vaccinated people in the Philippines should still wear face masks to prevent the spread of COVID-19. Dr. Eva Rojas says it's important for the public to keep following minimum public health measures since there are several variants of COVID-19 present in the Philippines. This reminder comes after the U.S. eased mask guidelines for fully vaccinated Americans.
Dito sa Pilipinas, alam naman po natin na hindi pa ganun karami ang nababakunahan. So yung coverage po is not as that as much of sa US. And then ang mga bakuna kasi na unang dumating sa atin dito, nung una wala pa talagang studies na ang bakuna na ito ay may transmission blocking capacity o yung nakakapigil ng pag-transmit. Ang benefit po talaga ng mga bakuna na unang dumating sa atin is to prevent the severe form of COVID-19.
Pfizer begins sending COVID-19 vaccines manufactured at its U.S. plant to other countries after a Trump-era export restriction expired. More in this report.
The U.S. will begin exporting Pfizer's COVID-19 vaccine to other countries. One source familiar with the matter exclusively told Reuters a shipment of Pfizer shots going to Mexico this week includes doses made in its U.S. plant. The source said it's the first time the drug maker is delivering the vaccines abroad from the U.S. That's after a Trump-era restriction on exporting Pfizer shots expired at the end of March. Pfizer and German partner BioNTech SE have so far been supplying other countries through its main European production plant in Belgium. Mexico has received 10 million doses of Pfizer shots so far and is expected to receive 2 million more this week. It's unclear how much of that will come from the U.S. Pfizer said it will be making 25 million shots every week in the U.S. by mid-year. That would mean successfully honoring a deal to deliver 300 million doses to the country by July. But as the U.S. swiftly vaccinates its population, many other countries are struggling to acquire vaccine supplies. They've repeatedly called on Washington to release its surplus in recent weeks. Pfizer has promised to deliver 1 billion doses to foreign governments and said it expects to produce up to 2.5 billion doses of its vaccine this year. The company said it will use its extra capacity in its U.S. facilities to deliver shots overseas.
The mayor of New York declares the city's five boroughs will fully reopen starting July 1st. Here's the full story.
We are ready to bring New York City back fully on July 1st.
New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio on Thursday said life in the Big Apple would finally get back to normal this summer after more than a year of coronavirus-related closures.
All systems go because you've earned it.
De Blasio said the biggest reason for reopening the most populous city in the U.S. was the success of its vaccination efforts. 6.3 million coronavirus vaccines have been administered in a city with over 8 million residents.
And we now can set this goal because we've been moving forward constantly, more and more vaccinations, fewer and fewer infections, thank God.
Today, Manhattan's Jacob Javits Convention Center is vaccinating thousands of New Yorkers a day. But last year, it was a field hospital. The pandemic was particularly harrowing for New York, once the epicenter of the outbreak. This time last year, hospitals were overwhelmed.
Ventilators, ventilators, ventilators.
The state governor was pleading for supplies. The city parked refrigerated trucks on a Brooklyn pier to store the bodies of victims. A Reuters aerial drone captured mass graves dug on Hart Island in the Bronx. A government website puts New York City's death toll at 32,000. De Blasio on Thursday prefaced his reopening announcement as the light at the end of the tunnel.
We can do this July 1st. We all got a little bit of work to do, but we can get there together.
He said restaurants, bars, theaters, and beaches would all reopen. And perhaps most importantly, tourism would be back.
This summer, this is going to be the summer of New York City.